Genesis, he's the breath of life. In Exodus, the Passover lamb. In Leviticus, he's our high priest. Numbers, fire by night. Deuteronomy, he's Moses' voice. In Joshua, he is salvation's choice. Judges, lawgiver. In Ruth, the kinsman redeemer. First and second Samuel, our trusted prophet. In Kings and Chronicles, he's sovereign. Ezra, a true and faithful scribe. In Nehemiah, he's the rebuilder of broken walls and lives. In Esther, he's Mordecai's courage. In Job, the timeless redeemer. In Psalms, he is our morning song. In Proverbs, wisdom's cry. Ecclesiastes, the time and season. In the Song of Solomon, he is the lover's dream. He is, he is, he is. In Isaiah, he's the Prince of Peace. Jeremiah, the weeping prophet. Lamentations, the cry for Israel. Ezekiel, he's the call from sin. And Daniel, the stranger in the fire. In Hosea, he is forever faithful. In Joel, he is the Spirit's power. In Amos, the arms that carry us. In He's the Lord our Savior. In Jonah, he's the great missionary. In Micah, the promise of peace. In Nahum, he is our strength and our shield. In Habakkuk and Zephaniah, he's pleading for revival. In Haggai, he restores. In Zechariah, our fountain. In Malachi, he's the Son of righteousness, rising with healing in his wings. He is, he is, he is. In Matthew, Mark, Luke and John, he is God, man, Messiah. In the book of Acts, he is the fire from heaven. In Romans, he's the grace of God. In Corinthians, the power of love. In Galatians, he is freedom from the curse of sin. Ephesians, our glory. Philippians, the servant's heart. In Colossians, he's the Godhead Trinity. Thessalonians, our coming King. And Timothy, Titus, Philemon, he's our mediator.